asked the question yet.
I'm talking.
So you're talking to Dubai, Middle East, and North Africa.
Oh, wow.
And I have to tell you, all my
girlfriends.
Dubai?
Dubai. Oh, Dubai, okay.
Middle East and North Africa. All my girlfriends. And all my guy friends are in love with you.
Wow. That's high praise.
A lot. Everybody, I was talking about you last weekend, actually, and it was just my chance.
Wow.
So you have a huge following there.
Oh, that's very nice to hear. That's so nice. Now, please reciprocate my love.
They're all watching right now.
Thank you for the love, and I'll send it right back to you.
So tell us, what drew you to the scripting this character, especially since it's something that we've all seen before in a different way and have associations with?
For me, it was exclusively about wanting to work with Michael Noyer, the filmmaker. Excuse me.
Why Michael?
I've been watching his work for many years. You know, he made three remarkable films before this, but his first film like blew me away. It's called R, a prison film called R, Hit Hard, Hit First, Hit Hardest. And then he did another film called Northwest in Copenhagen, about two brothers in the hood that have this aspirations, creating a little criminal empire for themselves. Both of them like sensational, like really authentic, naturalistic, sort of singular vision, sensibilities of filmmaker. I just thought he was amazing.
He told us about this movie, that it's actually for him a love story, which is something so different than what we associate with Chaplin.
I don't think so. It depends. If it's talking about the source material, certainly that relationship is less significant. It's almost like the Degas character, as in our film, is an amalgamation of a few different significant people. But yeah, I mean, it's a really wonderful opportunity, this film, because it's such a unifying environment, prison or war, where there's no context of anybody's life outside of this environment that they're all stuck in. And it's about these two guys who you would never expect. In the real world, sorry, I keep hitting your mic. In the real world, they never would enter each other's orbits. But in this world, because of necessity, they've ended up coming together. And it's this unlikely friendship that hopefully blooms into something that feels really significant and, you know, emotionally resonant.
Tell us about this unlikely friendship and your co-star that you're actually bringing this to life with,
Rami Malek. Rami, amazing. This picture came out of him, I think, yesterday or today or something, of him as Freddie Mercury. The first picture, he looked beautiful. He looked like Freddie Mercury. I couldn't believe it. He's
how
dope.
Is the onset chemistry?
He's just dope, you know. He's just a pro. He gets it. He's super, super talented and lovely to be around. Like, no drama, just a really smart, funny, like, accessible person. I loved him. Like, I've been really lucky with co-stars I've worked with recently. I had a face.
Maybe you draw the positivity in them.
Maybe. Maybe I was drawing the negativity for a while, because I had a phase where I worked with a bunch of idiots. I can't tell you. I mean, look up, you'll figure it out for yourself. But I went through a phase of working with idiots. But now, recently, the last two, three films I've done, I just worked with like really great people. So it's lovely. It makes all the difference in the world, because that's your life, you know?
It appears on set. There's no way on camera. Everything is there.
Right. And you hope that. But you can manufacture that even if it isn't there. But what you can't manufacture is quality of life. And when you work full-time making films, the people that you spend your time with are your life. You're spending 100 hours a week with these people. So if you think they're a bunch of idiots, then it's a long 10, 11, 12 big shoots.
You can't wait to get out.
Yeah. Adios.
So what was the most difficult thing for you in capturing this character? I mean, the story itself is quite harrowing for most viewers. So what was so difficult for you?
It's always difficult when you play a real person, because you feel like a great responsibility to that person.